Lecture, we already discussed the application of Bayer's rate law for a long straight line current conductor. Today, I will find out the field at the center of a circular coil by using Bayer's rate law. For this, we have to choose a circular wire having radius say A. Current going to, through this wire in this direction. We want to find out field at the point of O at the origin. For this, we choose a coordinate system, 2D coordinate system, that is XY coordinate system, in such a way that the origin of this coordinate system is coincide with the center of the circular wire. For considering a current element, we choose an elementary length dr prime or elementary arc, whatever may be. The distance of dr prime from the center, this is the source coordinate towards the center, and the angle between axis and the r prime is theta prime. Generally, we noticed r prime, theta prime, dr prime because all of this prime coordinate all of this prime coordinate are related to the source coordinate, whereas the r or normal non-prime coordinate are the field coordinate. Okay, in this coordinate system, r prime we can write equal to I cap a cos theta prime plus j cap a sin theta prime, where a is the radius of the circular wire and theta prime is the angle. We have also required dr prime. Now differentiate this equation r prime, we get dr prime. This will be a into I cap sin theta prime with a minus sign plus j cap cos theta prime into d theta prime. This portion I cap sin theta prime plus j cap cos theta prime is nothing but theta cap. Okay, now we require capital R vector for application of Bayer's rate law. Capital R vector is nothing but the relative. Actually, we don't need to replace this portion as theta prime cap. We can use this relation. Next, what is R vector? R vector is the relative position vector of the field coordinate with respect to the source coordinate. Here is the source coordinate, is a field coordinate is O, whose position vector is 0, 0, and the field coordinate is this point. So R vector equal to, we can write R minus R prime vector. R vector equal to 0 minus R prime vector. So it will be minus A I cap cos theta prime plus J cap sin theta prime. This R is nothing but the relative coordinate of the field point, means O, with respect to the source point, say any point on the arc. Clear? Now we want to find out magnetic field due to this elementary length at the O by using Bayer's rate law. What will be the magnetic field and what will be the direction? Current going out this direction, so magnetic field will be vertically upwards. Just throw your finger, it is vertically upwards with this source coordinate. That is, a magnetic field is directed vertically upward. Now the field at the center O due to this elementary length dr is represented by dbc. That is, magnetic field at the center dbc is the mu 0 by 4 pi into I dr prime cross r by r cube. All of you know this is a simple application of the Bayer's rate law. Now the case is, what is dr prime cross r? We can just find out dr prime cross r. Dr prime is a vector quantity, r is a vector quantity, so this is nothing but a cross b is a vector product. Okay, we can solve it by using determinant. Dr prime, the first component is minus a sin theta prime. Okay, I just take common minus a, this will be my sin theta prime. Second part is cos theta prime. There will be no k cap, so this will be 0. And in case of r vector, this first part is minus a cos theta prime, so this is a minus cos theta prime. And this will be sin theta prime. Now there is a in dr prime and there is a minus a in r prime, in r vector. Multiplication of these two constant gives you minus square. So finally, if you solve this determinant, I think all of you know how to solve the determinant, then it will be minus square into minus k cap d theta prime. So finally it will be k cap square d theta prime. Just see, there is no element in the form, in the third column, without k cap. So when you consider this, only k cap exists and the others on will be null, will cancel out. That's why k cap square d theta prime. We use this value, we use this expression, dvc equal to mu 0 by 4 pi I dr r cross r by r cube. I dr prime cross r is this, the mu 0 I by 4 pi k cap square d theta prime. And what is r? If we want to fill out at the center, then r equal to a, so it will be 4 pi a cube. Finally, it will be mu 0 by 4 pi I, and this is addition k cap d theta prime by a. This is dvc. Okay, this is equation 2. Now each elementary length of this wire, of this circular well, gives you this type of magnetic field, and all this magnetic field are in the upward direction. So the total magnetic field at the center of the circular wire is nothing but the integration of dvc. This will give you this one, because all these are constant. All over the integral d theta prime gives you the 2 pi. Cancel from both sides. So finally, it will be k cap mu 0 I by 2 a. So the magnetic field at the center of the circular wire, k cap mu 0 I by 2 a. So the magnetic field at the center of the circular wire is k cap mu 0 I by 2 a. You can, when you solve a different type of problems, you can use this expression like this: k cap mu naught by 4 pi into 2 pi I by a. What is the utility of this equation? All of you know mu 0 equal to 4 pi times 10 to the power minus 7. So this gives you k cap 10 to the power minus 7 into 2 pi by a into I. This is a very beautiful expression.